हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज श्रवण। दिस इज माय यूट्यूब चैनल सिविल इंजीनियरिंग बाय श्रवण। टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल क्लिक ऑन सब्सक्राइब बटन एंड क्लिक ऑन बेल आइकन फॉर मोर इंटरेस्टिंग अपडेट्स। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू मॉडलिंग एंड एनालिसिस ऑफ G+5 बिल्डिंग विथ शियर वॉल एट डिफरेंट लोकेशन बाई यूजिंग स्टैट प्रो V8A सॉफ्टवेयर। सो बेसिकली शियर वॉल्स आर द मेंबर्स विच आर यूजफुल फॉर रिडक्शन ऑफ एर्थक्वेक लोडिंग कंडीशन। If you apply shear walls for that respected building, it will be automatically decrease your respected intensity of the seismic loading condition. So with the help of this technique also, we can design earthquake resistant structure. So in this video, I will explain you the modeling part as well as analysis part for that respected G+5 building by using StatPro software. So click on StatPro software here. So click on new project. Click on spacing option. Give the structure name. Just I am taking it as G+5. So save your file location as per your requirement. So here we have to select the length units will be in meter as well as force units will be in kilonewton. Click on next button, click on finish button. So now the software will be open like this. So it will be consisting of 10 number of grids in x direction condition as well as 10 number of grids in y direction condition. So initially we have to model this respective G+5 building. So for that, go to geometry option, click on run structure wizard option. So it will open your model type like this. So in this we have to select the frame models, select the bay frame options. So here we have to enter the length of the building, height of the building, width of the building, number of bays along length direction, number of bays along height direction, number of bays along width direction. So here I am assuming length will be consisting of 21. Again I am taking height of the building is 18 meter. Again I am taking width of the building is also 18 meter. So after that we have to enter the number of bays along length, just I am taking it as 7. Again we have to enter the number of bays along height, just I am taking it as 6. Again you have to enter the number of bays along width direction, just I am taking it as 6. Click on apply button. So this is my model for that respected G+5 story building. So we have to import this respected model from structure wizard option to StatPro software. So for that, click on cancel button, click on yes button, click on OK. So now you can see the model is imported to this respected StatPro software like this. So after that, click on hide snap node grid. So for this respected structure, we have to add the slab portion. So for that, click on cut section command, click on select preview, click on OK. So here I am selecting ground story for this respective structure. So after adding the slab section for the ground story, I will copy the same properties to the remaining two stories. So initially we have to select the 4-node plate. For select first point, select second point, select third point, select fourth point. So I was assigned that respected slab section at this respected point. So we have to copy this respected property in x direction as well as y direction. Okay, so for that, go to transitional repeat in x direction. So number of steps will be consisting of 6 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So after that, in the same way, we have to copy this respected property in z direction also. Select that properties, go to transitional repeat in z direction, number of stories are 5 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. Now you can see all the properties are assigned for this respective story at the ground. So after that, we have to select whole structure command here. We have to copy this respective ground story slab to the remaining 5 stories. So for that, go to transitional repeat again. Again in the same way, we have to select in y direction condition. Why? Because we have to copy this respective placed in y direction condition only. So here I am entering number of steps are 5 and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK. So it will create this respected plates for this respected section here like this. So after creating this respected plates, we have to create the shear wall sections. So for adding the shear wall sections, initially we will go with surface commands option. Okay. So for that, initially we have to select the top view. So here we have to select the cut section. We have to select to view option. Click on OK. Now here we have to cut this respected portion. So for this respected section, initially we have to add the shear wall. So for that, we have to select the add surface. So we have to select the first point, select second point, third point, fourth point. In the same way, come to the first point. In the same way, we have to select the node points here like this. Again, in the same way, we have to select the node points. So after that, we have to click on whole structure command. In the same way, we have to keep the top story. Okay, so after that we have to go to click on cut section command. In the same way, we have to select the cut section, select to view, click on OK. So here we have to select the beam cursor. We have to cut this respected right hand side section for this respected story here like this. So for this respected section also we have to add the surfaces. So for that click on add surface here. First point, select second point, select third point, select fourth point. Again come to first point. The same way just I am selecting second point, third point, fourth point, first point. Again go to select first, second, third point, fourth point, first point. So after that we have to click on whole structure again. Again we have to click on top story. So select cut section, select to view, click on OK. So here we have to select the beam. So we have to cut this respected section here. Now again we have to add this respected add surface. Select the first point. In the same way we have to select second, third, fourth. Again come to the first point. Now in the same way we have to add the remaining section also. Now I am selecting first node point here, second node point, third node point, fourth node point, come to the first point. Now in the same way just I am selecting first node point, second node point, third node point, fourth node point, come to the first point. So after that click on whole structure in the sense. So after that we have to select the top view. In the same way we have to add this respected shear wall section on the left hand side also. So for that go to click on cut section, select to view, click on OK, select this respected option. Cut this respected portion. So initially we have to left this respected corner. So after that we have to select the surface, first point, second point, third point, fourth point, again come to the first point. Now select first, second, third, fourth, come to the first point. The same way we have to select first point, second point, third point, fourth point, come to the first point. So after that click on whole structure command. Now we can see the shear walls are assigned for this respected building in alternative position for this respected G plus 5 story structure. So after assigning the shear walls, we have to give the properties for this respected building. Properties are nothing but giving the beam size, column size as well as slab thickness, shear wall thickness for this respected structure. So initially we have to define those respected properties. So further select general. So here we have to click on property define option. So here I am selecting 0.35 cross 0.35 is the beam size. Click on add button. Again I am adding 0.35 cross 0.5 is the column size. Click on add button. Close option. So after that we have to select the thickness. So here I am considering plate thickness will be consisting of 150 mm. Click on add button. So after that select the surface thickness. So here I am taking it as 120 mm. Click on add button. Close option. So after that select this 0.35 cross 0.35, we have to assign this respective property for the beam sections. So for that we have to select the beams which are parallel to x axis. Again we have to select the beams which are parallel to z axis. Click on assign to selected beams. Assign yes. So after that we have to select the 0.35 cross 0.5. We have to select the columns which are parallel to vertical direction, nothing but y direction. Click on assign to selected beams. Assign yes. Select the plate thickness with the help of assign to view option. Assign yes option. Select the surface thickness. Assign to view. Assign yes. So after that we have to assign the supports for this respective structure. So for that select supports. Click on create option. Add your fixed supports. Select your support 2 with the help of front view option. We have to assign this respected supports at the base. Click on select assign to selected nodes. Assign yes option. So now we can see fixed supports are assigned for this respected structure here like this. So after that we have to see this respected whole model in rendering view. Okay, so in the rendering view is nothing but your final view for this respected structure. So for that we have to click on rendering view option, 3D rendering view. So this is my 3D rendering view for this respected structure. It will be consisting of G plus 5 story, which is having 0.35 cross 0.35 is the beam size and 0.35 cross 0.5 is the column size. Slab thickness will be consisting of 150 mm and the shear wall thickness will be consisting of 120 mm. So after modeling process completed, we have to apply the load cases for this respective structure. So for that initially we have to click on general option. So here I am selecting loads and definitions option. So basically shear walls are comes under your earthquake resistance structures. So for that initially we have to define the seismic loading condition. So for that select plus mark, select seismic definitions, click on add. So here I am selecting IS code. So click on generate option. So it will open your IS 1893 parameters like this. So here I am selecting high seismic zone. which is comes under your zone 5 condition with 0.36 is the seismic coefficient value. So here I am selecting special RC moment resisting frames with the factor 5 and importance factor is 1. So here I am selecting other parameters which is related to medium soil condition. So here I am clicking on generate option. So it will generate this respected parameters like this here. So here we have to edit this respected value to 5%. Click on add button. So after that we have to select the self weight as 1, add it. Now we have to select the member weights. So we have to select this respected concentrated or uniform load. So here I am selecting it as uniform condition. Why? Because dead load of a beam will be comes under your uniform loading condition only. So here we have to calculate that respected intensity. Just I am taking 0.35 cross 0.35 is the size of that respected beam. We have to multiply this respected value with 25. So it will give the value of 3.0625 value here. So here we have to input this respected value 3.0625. Click on add button, close option. Now we have to select this respected uniform what we call weight. So we have to select beam is parallel to x axis. Again I have to select the beam is parallel to z axis. Click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. In the same way we have to define the wind loading condition. So select wind definitions, click on add button. So click on type 1 wind 1, add it, close option. So select your type 1 wind 1, click on add button. So here we have to import this respected intensity as per the height. So here I am taking some random values for this respected height, which is of 18. So if you want to calculate this respected intensity as per IS 875 code, so I will provide you that video link in below description. Please watch that video. So here I am selecting this respected intensity of 0.5, which is acting at a distance of 9 meter. Again I am taking 0.2, which is at 6, 0.1, which is acting at a distance of 3 meter. Click on add button. So after that we have to add the exposure factor. So here I am adding it as 1, add. Okay, so after that click on close option. So it was added 2 exposure factor here. So after that select exposure 1, click on assign to view, assign yes option. So after that we have to add this load case details. So select load case details, click on add button. So initially we have to select this respective load cases, which is comes under your seismic loading condition. So here I am selecting it as earthquake load in x direction, add button. Again we have to select earthquake load in z direction, add button. So in the same way just I am selecting wind load, which is in x direction condition, add it. Again I am selecting wind load in z direction, add it. So again I am selecting dead loading condition, next load case, add it as DL. Again I am selecting it as live loading condition. So here I am selecting title as LL, add button, close option. So after that select earthquake load in x direction condition, click on add button. So here we have to select the seismic load. So here I am selecting seismic load, which is in x direction with the factor 1, add button, close option. Now in the same way we have to select the y direction load case, add. Select seismic load with the z direction, factor 1, add, close. Select wind x, click on add button. So here I am selecting wind load, which is in x direction, windward facing with the factor 1, add it. Again I am selecting factor as minus 1, opposite direction, add button, close option. Now select your wind load in z direction, click on add button. So in the same way just I am selecting wind load in z direction, wind facing with the factor 1, add button. Again I am selecting it as minus 1 factor, add button, close option. Now in the same way we have to select the dead loading condition, click on add button. So here we have to add the self weight, close option. So here we have to select the live load, click on add button. So here I am selecting floor load, which is consisting of minus 2.5 is the intensity, which is acting at a distance of 3 and 18 meter. Click on add button, close option. So after that check your respected y range value. So this is the live load action rate for this respected structure. Select the self weight with the help of assign to view option, assign yes. So after that we have to add the load combinations. So select load case details, for that click on add button. Select auto load combinations here. So here we have to select the Indian standard code, click on generate option. So it will add your load combinations for this respected structure here like this. Click on add button, close option. So these are the load combinations. So after that select the materials option, select the concrete material, click on assign to view option, assign yes option. So after that, go to analysis and print, add your no print option, close option, go to analyze option, run analysis, save it. So here we have to check for the zero errors for this respective structure. So here my model is checking for the zero errors. So here my model is observed with zero errors. Go to post processing mode, click on done option, click on apply, click on OK. So this is the deflection diagram for this respective structure due to presence of dead loading condition. So this is the deflection diagram due to X direction seismic load, Z direction, wind load X, wind load Z, dead load condition, live load condition. So this is the load combination deflection. So after that, select beam. So select this respective Fy value. So this is a shear force diagram for this respective structure. So you can check the values of this respective intensity on the right hand side table. So after that, select Mz. So this is the bending moment diagram. Red color diagram indicates your bending moment diagram for this respective structure with the intensities on the right hand side table. So select plate load. Apply your stress type as let us consider it as absolute pressure. Click on apply, click on OK. So this is the diagram which is related to earthquake load X direction, Z direction, wind load X, wind load Z, dead load condition, live load condition. This is the load combinations diagram. So after that, select surface in the same way, add a plate as absolute pressure, click on apply, click on OK. So in the same way, we have to change this respective intensity. So this is the diagram which is related to this respected option. Okay, so this is the process modeling and analysis of this respective structure by using StatPro software. So in my upcoming video, I will explain you the design of this respected building and the shear wall design by using StatPro V8A software. Thank you.